Morning. Hey, I'm Gabe Haydu, and I'm a fifth grade teacher at Singapore American School.
You ready to do this?
Yeah, let's go. Oh, wait one second, let me grab my board. Welcome to my morning commute, and let me tell you a little bit about how I got into teaching. I was an international relations major. I knew I wanted to travel and I wanted to do business, but something inside me said that that wasn't quite enough. That wasn't what I was meant to do. Everyone was saying, you know, you need to be working with kids. You belong in the classroom. Whew, what a ride in. Let me get ready for the day. Behold. Welcome to Mr. Haydu's room. I didn't even catch that. What's that?
Parallelogram.
What's your favorite song or band?
Oh, I told you this.
Oh, man. The Final Countdown.
Yes.
It's the Final Countdown. Some of you didn't have a chance to take the math test yesterday, or you chose not to take the test yesterday, and you chose to have an extra day of review, which I really respect. Those of you who did that, like, that was an awesome choice. I'm gonna review quickly with some of the people who are going to take the test today. I'm gonna pull you aside, review with you at the carpet. Those of you who already took the test yesterday are going to be working, you're gonna dive straight into the project. So, maintain the core knowledge aspect, be creative. There are some options for you, okay? You could create some sort of a geometry project. I'm not really sure what that would look like, as long as you're using our vocabulary words and you're talking about the geometry concepts, be creative and go for it. Or if you need something that's more guided, yesterday you guys started off on that party math, and so I've got different stations throughout the room. Choose one activity and try to stick with it for the whole math period and do something really deep and creative with it.
Is a rhombus always a rectangle? Well, a rectangle definition is must have four right angles. And a rhombus can be drawn like this. Does this have four right angles? No. So that means rhombus can't be on the bottom while rectangle's on the top.
But you need to check the camera and resize.
It's picture. It's
I want you to research Sierpinski's triangle and Pascal's triangle.
I
want you to find, you know Sierpinski's triangle already? Oh, yes. All right, now see if you can find a way to make connections between Sierpinski's triangle, Pascal's triangle, and the work that you're doing right here. Come here. What you can't see is that I actually left those magnets up on the board this morning. I didn't mention them at all, knowing that they would spark a little bit of interest in some of my students who kind of might be a little bit beyond what we're talking about. Do you have a reluctant reader? Here are some pro tips to get them reading. Series books, they're huge. Students really, really love digging into a storyline that they can follow from book to book. Maybe it's too hard to read, so audio version. Singapore books. I mean, these are written by Singaporeans for an audience in Singapore. Tiny books. Tiny books are fun. Big books full of tiny stories. They're great. Very digestible. Poetry. Everyone loves a good poem, especially if it's Roald Dahl. I mean, who doesn't love Roald Dahl? Classics. Gruesome. Man, if you have a reluctant reader and you give them a book about the Donner Party, Google it if you don't know. It can be a really great way to hook them. Choose something that is your favorite, like Hatchet. I love this book. What's that you say? You've got a kid who only wants to look at their iPad? Digitize a book.
Jane Goodall is a UN messenger of peace.
there are some really awesome gems in here that we bought for you guys. Check these out. You know, have you ever seen them on TV? Yeah? So cool, look at these. This is the Diary of Amos Lee. Donner Dinner Party. It's a comic book. All about the Donner Party.
What? Can I trade it?
Can you trade it? You
want? I'll trade it.
They're clamoring for these books. One thing you'll notice right now is that I didn't necessarily give them a call to action, but you can see they're dispersing right now. They kind of know from the natural flow of things that this is their cue to go ahead and grab a book, cuddle up, find a cozy spot, and dive into their stories. So, sometimes I take this counseling lesson time to do some grading. I like to stay in the room though because I get to hear what the counselors are talking about with the students and I can bring that back into my lessons too.
One of my favorite lessons is social studies because I love learning about the world and I love learning about like for example Cape Town, we're learning about that and the water crisis.
Last time we were together talking about Cape Town, what were some of the things we discussed?
This has been one of the worst droughts in 100 years.
Aquifers in Cape Town, but they don't want to dig wells there because there's an endangered species of plants growing.
Use their dirty bath water and put it in the back of the toilet so they would have water to flush.
Oh, I wonder what systems are actually in place for saving the precious water that's there. Your mission is to think of what can we do? Think of some innovative solutions to this Cape Town water crisis. What can we do? What can they do?
One of my favorite things about Mr. Haydu's class is scholarly time, because you can do anything basically that's scholarly, which is really fun.
Is it gonna be a viable print? A massive part of my school life for the past 5 months has been robotics after school. And oh my goodness, these kids can do amazing things. This year, the FLL teams that we had here at SAS really just rocked it. I mean, you can see right here, they walked away with 6 trophies in total. None of this would be possible without Mr. Gatch though. Huge shout out to him. He's really rocked it with these kids.
Oh my goodness.
It's 3:10 and they're still here. Go be kids. Get out of here.
I'm not a kid.
No more school.
Bye, Mr. Alvin.
See ya.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, you remember when I hid behind the couch?
That was so funny. Wow. Bye.
You didn't. Your mom is right. Bye. Bye. Bye.
No! That was an awesome day. Thank you so much for joining me. One thing that I always think about when I'm leaving is, did my students have fun? Did they learn something new? And did they show evidence of their learning or come away with a tool that they can bring into the next day? So I kind of think about that the same way I think about myself when I'm in professional development. But anyway, I hear the thunder. I think the rain is gonna start coming, so I gotta head home for the weekend. Thanks for joining me. Bye.